should score every time. Okay? So here, good position. He's driving through me. He has the beat on my sprawl. I turn my foot. I push his shoulder out here. Sink deep, lock in the crotch. Notice I'm not dropping straight to my butt. I know a lot of guys that have taught this series or this move are taught, okay, when he beats you here, drop straight to your butt and scoop. But that's not what I want. I want you to be here. I want you to be here. Feel that, turn that foot out like this. Feel that shoulder. Sink this deep. Step around. I want to use this as my pivot point. Most of my weight is going right here through this leg. Alright? So here, I'm pivoting around with this foot because I want to get this locked right here in the crotch. Now, once I have that locked in the crotch, now I'm taking his weight to his head. Okay? The one thing that he beat me here is what? He slips that head underneath, right? So if I'm here, I get this locked, and I'm circling around, and he goes head underneath here, now he can elevate that leg and put me in a bad spot. But if I have this crotch lock here, and I have all my weight here on his foot, he dips that head under, I'm sagging all my weight towards his head, I still have this lock here, hooking this inside leg, just like that. Hips up and score. So one more time, a little bit quicker. It takes that shot, it's a deep push back, and get right here. I'm pivoting off this foot, this leg is going around, step. As he moves, he might try to scoot, try to get away. I gotta get this locked, take my weight towards him, here, get that hooked, bring my hips up to the score on that curve. Any questions? It's a little bit complicated. It's a little bit goofy. But I promise you, this is really solid secondary defense to a high crossing attack. Any questions?